Introduce each other in the usual way for fear of repetition.
Yeah, and we'll try not to
hesitate. And we definitely won't deviate.
No, we won't, but I thought you were going to wear that dress you were wearing.
It was a bit uncomfortable, a bit tight.
That's right.
I had to change last minute anyway.
Yeah, no, none of that tonight because we are joined by the stars of Radio 4's Just a Minute.
Nicholas, Tony and Gyles.
Repetition or deviation. So we'll try and give them a little excerpt to start with you, Tony Hawks. I know the subject. Brilliant idea.
Go on.
Just a minute.
Perfect.
You talk on just a minute. 60 seconds if you can, starting now.
Just a Minute is a brilliant radio panel game that has been running for 45 years, and now at last it will be coming to television, which will give us the chance, the panelists, to show just how beautiful we are to the public.
Repetition, did you say just?
Yeah. No, you're allowed to repeat the subject.
Yeah,
we'll give you a bonus point. We'll try.
Yeah. Good go.
Right,
Charles.
Take over. Yes. This extraordinary game was invented by a man called Ian Messiter almost a lifetime ago. In the early days on wireless, people like Kenneth Williams, Peter Jones, Derek Nimmo, they played this. Curious that this particular actor did, because he had something of a stutter. Also, my favourite, the late lamented Sir Clement Freud. Superb, this extraordinary divertissement, now presented on an alternative.
Deviation, he's speaking French now.
We're going to whistle. There we are.
Irritating with them.
I got here today, Nicholas?
No, I didn't. Oh, but I still respect them.
Yes,
and I think that more people should do it.
Yes. Well, Nicholas and Tony, what does Gyles usually tell you about his little times here on the Watch? I bet he tells you that he goes off making films all about classical music, church organs, Charles Dickens, imagine.
Yeah, well, all of that is true. But he'd also dabble in anything we ask him to. He's not fussy, really, you know. Even if it involves him getting into a bit of a fight.
The streets of Victorian Britain cities were a terrifying and violent place. Lowlifes and vicious gangs with names like the Garrotters and Scuttlers roamed, looking for easy pickings. The gentlemen and ladies of late Victorian London were increasingly fearful for their lives whenever they left the safety of their homes to take the air in the city streets. In the 1890s, one man countered this life of fear with a gentle. If I'm ever confronted by a garrotter or a scuttler, I can fend them off with techniques used by Sherlock Holmes.
Go on, Charles. Go on, man. Yeah, look at that. I tell you what, there's a couple of other dodgy-looking Victorians in the audience tonight as well, Gyles, so, you know, part it soon, all that business. But, Nicholas, you were just telling us there, you're a fan of Grapple.
Oh, yes, I did judo when I was younger. And partly because I want to introduce my son to it, he was very keen. I've still got the judo gears. I mean, I feel...
Did you put it on at all?
Yeah, oh, yes, you have to. Yeah. You have to wear that because it's particularly strong. And you can grab people like that. You can do it. I rose to be a green belt.
To host Just a Minute. And at the beginning, 45 years ago, you fancied being a panellist, didn't you?
No, I was due to be the panellist.
Oh, right.
I took the investor's idea. Well, Jimmy Edwards was going to be the chairman. He was never available on a Sunday when they wanted to record the pilot. As you know, they record a pilot, and if the powers have been like it, then they commission a series. And David Hatch, who was the producer then, said, listen, I can never get Jimmy on a Sunday. You be chairman for the pilot, and if we get the series, you go on the panel. I said, okay. And I did this, but it wasn't a good pilot. They didn't want it. No way did they want it. And David Hatch fought for it. And in the end, he got his way, and he came to me and said, we're stuck with it now. He said, the one thing they liked was your chairmanship.
And that was it. And there's been some classic moments since. Let's have a look. Here we go. That we saw there was quite daunting, taking up from the likes of, you know,
it was. I first went on in 1992, and it was a programme. I listened to that growing up, so yeah. I would have listened to those people, and I was invited to go on, and you're sitting there with your kind of hero, your childhood hero, and it's terrifying.
Yeah.
Because actually, they weren't that kind to newcomers.
No. They all wanted to win. They were absolutely, gave no quarter at all.
Nobody said, oh, you'll be fine. They actually wanted you to fail horribly.
Did they, yeah? The worst thing is, when it's radio, it's just your voice, and you become so conscious about you know, what you're saying, and it's so intimate, isn't it?
It is, but I think radio is quite relaxing, because obviously you don't have to go, we've all been in makeup for 3.5 hours. Well, Nicholas. But I mean, I think it's very, you just crack on with it, you know.
It's incredible, an adrenaline rush. I mean, I first started in the 1980s with people like Kenneth Williams, Peter Jones, but never with Derek Nimmo. Because
you know why, don't you?
Why?
Because originally I suggested that you should do it, and they said, oh, we can't have him. He sounds on radio a little bit like Derek Nimmo.
Look, distraught.
Once Derek died, you were on, and you won your Spurs and proved
it's not. That's a terrible thing to say. Oh, I'm so sorry. I feel, oh dear, I hope you don't
mind. But now that you're there,
it's all right.
You're a part of the institution. You're one of our regulars, one of the ones they're most loved.
And what's interesting about the television version, though, is they recorded it exactly as if it were the radio.
Yes.
If you watch next week on BBC Two, you'll be seeing, in a sense, almost the radio recording, but done for a television audience.
Let's have a little look at that. Before we talk about it anymore, here we are. But, Jazz, what I wanted to know is, do you get the subjects before you go on radio or go on air to do the telly programme? Do you know what they are?
No.
Can you prepare?
The people who devise them know the sort of thing that you might be able to talk about.
Yeah.
But no, and the joy of this is that it is a live competition. A minute is a minute by anybody's standards. The clock is ticking. You've got to work against the clock. I mean, it's not necessarily good for one's heart, but I have been taking gas.
Yeah. I mean, I think what's interesting is actually that Paul was doing very well there, and he's brilliant at it, but very often it's fun. can't hear when you see people flail and failing horribly. Which is usually my role. But that's it's the fun of it, isn't it? I mean, you don't have to be good. You just have to try. And
I think the wonderful thing is it is an entirely improvised game. And that's why some of the new younger comedians have come in are so good at it, because they've grown up in the world of improvised comedy. And to keep going, it requires great discipline of thought and mind.
Yeah.
And also to try and be clever and witty and amusing. I mean, Gyles is brilliant. These two are wonderful exponents of the game, and so is Paul, whom you've just seen.
Yeah, and I mean, the beauty, obviously, is the language. And for the 45th anniversary, you went over to India. Now, this is an interesting story.
Wonderful.
We haven't got that much time, but give us an idea of why you went to India.
Well, because ever since you went out on the World Service, it spawned what they call jam clubs, those are initials. And it's so popular over there, I arrived and discovered I had a whole fan club in India. And we went to Bangalore, we made a film about doing Just a Minute in India. Then we went to Mumbai and we recorded two versions of the show, which one went out on Monday and the next one's going out next Monday, with Paul Merton and Marcus Brigstock, who flew out, and two Indian stand-ups, and they were sensational.
Brilliant. Super job. And Just a Minute, the series starts. It's 2 weeks run on BBC Two from next Monday at 6 p.m.
Yes, and you can catch Nicholas and all the gang at their usual BBC Radio 4 slot on Monday night at 6:30 p.m.
Right, stand by. It's over Leicester. It's over Milton Keynes. Stand by Tony. There it is. Gyles, you're more than happy to run the mile, aren't you?
I'm ready. I can't wait to start.
It's
the Mohegan haircut I'm nervous about, but we're running.
I can't believe that. I didn't even know he took the guard off or anything like that. But anyway, he'll be straight into the barbers there.
Yeah.
But anyway, from just a mile to just a minute, we're being inundated with people who love the show. What's the biggest tip you've got for talking for a minute without any of the three?
I find when you're stuck and you get a subject you don't know what to talk about, I go for a bit of emotion. So if
emotion.
I get something like ashtrays or something, I'm passionate about ashtrays.
There we are.
That's a good way of
top tip. And thanks to Nicholas, Tony and Gyles. The TV version of Just a Minute starts next Monday, 6 p.m. on BBC Two.
And you can also catch the team on their regular Radio 4 slot every Monday. On tomorrow's show, we are joined by two of the coaches from BBC's The Voice, Tom Jones and Danny O'Donoghue. We'll see you then. Bye.
Bye-bye. Thanks again.